Please welcome the engineers. Once again, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Rensselaer Houston Fieldhouse for tonight's matchup between the Big Green of Dartmouth and your engineers of RPI. Let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First, the visitors from Dartmouth College. At left wing is a junior from Concord, Massachusetts, number 11, Mark Gallant. At center for Dartmouth, the freshman from Caledonia, Ontario, number 15, Sean Chisholm. And at right wing is a senior from Elmhurst, Illinois, number 26, Jeff Lacerdo. On defense, a freshman from Edgewater, New Jersey, number 23, Ian Pierce. And a senior from Andover, Massachusetts, number 2, Harrison Marco. In the goal for Dartmouth is a sophomore from Port Coquitlam, British Columbia, number 33, Clay Stevenson. The rest of the Big Green and their head coach, Reed Cashman. And now let's meet the starting lineup for the engineers of RPI. At left wing for RPI, a senior from Espoo, Finland, number 11, Anoville Lepinen. At center is a senior from Great Falls, Virginia, number 19, Tor Linden. And at right wing for the engineers, a senior from Bratislava, Slovakia, number 39, Jacob Laka. On defense, he's a senior from Bloomington, Minnesota, number 23, Jake Johnson. And a sophomore from Oakville, Ontario, number 6, Jack Agnew. In the goal for the engineers is a freshman from Toronto, Ontario, number 34, Jack Watson. The rest of the engineers, their head coach is Dave Smith. He's assisted by Chuck Weber and Matthias Lannan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to honor and respect our two great countries and the men and women who have served and continue to serve, we ask that you please rise, remove your hats as the RPI Pep Band plays the national anthems of Canada and the United States of America. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Houston Fieldhouse for tonight's ECAC hockey matchup here on RPI TV and ESPN. It's the Dartmouth Big Green taking on the homestanding RPI Engineers. Alongside the coach, Dan Fridge, and I'm Perilous Garris. We welcome you into the Houston Fieldhouse on the campus of Troy. The campus of RPI, Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York. Coach, two games left in the regular season. RPI has a couple of tough opposition despite their record. Dartmouth's been playing some pretty good hockey as of late. They've won three of the last four.
Yeah, the last four games are 3-1. RPI can sit here 2-2. Haven't split the last couple of weekends. So a big home stand for them. Last regular season, home games, and looking for a lot of excitement.
So we do have the Engineers a chance to lock up a middle four spot in the league. And of course, on the men's side, the top four teams in the conference get a bye to the first round of the playoffs. The middle four host the bottom four. So you're in the six through nine spots there. Excuse me, five through nine. That's where RPI still has an outside shot at a bye, but they need a lot of help and to win two games to get there.
Yeah, they need to win two games, and Cornell would have to lose both games. Anything can happen.
Right.
I know Coach Schaefer, they haven't been the same since Coach Schaefer hasn't been behind the bench, and I don't think he made the trip this past weekend or this weekend.
Underway here at the Houston Fieldhouse, RPI and Dartmouth. The Engineers took the opening game of this season series 2-0 up in Hanover a few weeks ago. It was one of those makeup Tuesday games. They got a win, and Jack Watson, who's in net tonight for RPI, picked up the shutout, one of his three on the year.
He had a conversation with Reed Cashman, who's in his second year as the head coach of the Big Green at Dartmouth. Considers his team pretty young. They got six freshmen and six sophomores dressed tonight.
Out to center, Jake Johnson's gonna shoot it in. In goal for Dartmouth is sophomore Clay Stevenson. He's a big kid, 6'4", 195. 5-10-2 record on the year, 2.60 goals against, 925 save percentage. Otto Ville-Leppinen works it back to the point for Johnson. Johnson's shot is blocked. It caught the skate of Lacerdo. It'll be dumped down. This is gonna be icing on Dartmouth as Lacerdo, stepped over the bench, but I think he knew full well he'd be coming back on the icing call.
Yeah, sort of blocked the shot, and then Gallant tried to hit him with a pass, but put it up.
To Quinnipiac, 5-0, and beat Princeton 2-0. He's knocked off the stick of Jacob Lee on his way into the zone. Jack Cameron turning it around for Dartmouth. Now it's going to be Laurie Surdy. Awkward collision there on Mashey, but he was able to help it out to center. And it'll be dumped in again over Watson off the glass. Surdy back to get it. Sophomore from Espoo, Finland. Ahead for Jacob Laka, and now Zach Davinsky. And they're offside as that puck kind of rode along the blue line. And Mashey stepped across before the puck, apparently. 17:29 to go first period. We're scoreless here at the Houston Fieldhouse.
Kind of a mixed lineup there where Leppinen got out there with Mashey and Davinsky.
Now Leppinen, Otto Ville has been taking some faceoffs recently. He's had some pretty decent success with Tuur Linden lining up on the wing where he's been a center just about all year. We'll be another icing call, a chance to draw it up again. But Leppinen on the draw this year, small sample size, but he's won 61% of his draws, 61.5% of his faceoffs coming into tonight. I'll take another one here.
He's got that low center of gravity, which allows him to get down on the stick and really put some fulcrum on that faceoff.
Up against Sean Chisholm of Dartmouth, and again, Chisholm wins the faceoff. This is shot into the middle. Leppinen gets a touch to it, tried to poke it behind. As Jacob Laka was waiting for it. Very veteran lineup there. Three seniors with Laka, Leppinen, and Linden. Now trying to break the split the D was Gallant there, but he's cut off. Mason Klee with a nice play to work it to the wall. Now in the air to center, Leppinen tried to glove it, but lost it. Laka will backtrack, senior from Bratislava, Slovakia. Markel intercepts at center, moves it into the attacking zone. Harrison Markel centering pass, loose in the slot. It'll be peeled out there blocked by Hessler. Now a shot from the blue line is blocked as Sorkin gave an attempt, and that outlet pass going to be out of the reach of Adamo on an icing call here against RPI.
Yeah, I don't know if that was Klee that took that shot for the block.
Yeah, the RPI's blocked a few shots early here.
Which is a good thing. It's a little thing that goes a long way, and you just need to be consistent with it from a defensive perspective.
To the line and kept in by Walsh. Dartmouth to center. Hessler backhands it in. Jake Johnson over to get it. Senior from Bloomington. Could be playing in his last two games here at the Houston Fieldhouse, although rather unlikely. RPI close to securing a first-round home series. Stephen Townley twisting and turning. Shot gets to goal. Save made. Puck still loose there. Right back to the blue line. A drive and they score. Jack Cameron with his third goal of the season. And the Halifax, Nova Scotia native gives the Big Green a 1-0 lead.
Well, that was just a tremendous shot by Cameron. Got some traffic in front of Watson. He was down, and he put that thing top shelf over the blocker. I don't think Watson even saw that puck shot from the point based on the traffic that was in front of him.
Dartmouth goal was scored by number 7, Jack Cameron. He was assisted by number 14.
1-0 Big Green here.
Time of the goal, 4 minutes, 27 seconds.
Ian Pierce.
Dartmouth goal, 7 Cameron.
30 fires one in, was kicked away by Stevenson.
4:27.
Another shot goes wide. The Big Greens score on their first shot on goal of the game. Was their fifth attempt. RPI had done a good job getting in front of pucks towards net. It'll be lifted ahead and dumped in by Kyle Hallbauer, senior from Howell, New Jersey. Former Lone Star Brahmas. Is this going to be another icing here against the Big Green?
Yeah, Watson couldn't do anything on that shot. A lot of traffic in front. He was in the butterfly, and it was just a really well-placed one-timer by the junior, Jack Cameron. Home of RPI alumni, Mike McPhee.
Trying to jam it in front. Lepinen was there. Now Baxter sent behind for Lepinen. Shelberg. Shelberg across. Baxter waiting. Still Baxter. Backhand shot. Save me. Stevenson with a nice stop there. Baxter showed some patience there in front of goal for a defenseman. That was a nice play. Just couldn't miss the netminder there.
Yeah, nifty little play there to hold on to it. He knew that the Dartmouth player was going to commit to trying to block the shot. Showed some patience, good hands, and took the backhand. Stevenson staying square to the shot. Got it right in the bread basket and held on.
Face-off win for RPI, kept in there by Agnew. Jack Agnew steered towards goal by Herman on a redirection, but it went wide. Shane Seller. And still the last Dartmouth Big Green to put up 4 assists in the game, and it came here at this rink. Long shot, this flush, and they score! It's Jake Gagno with his first collegiate tally, and Shane Sellers quick to go pick that thing up. As we're all tied here. A nice redirection in front for Gagno, and we're all knotted at one apiece.
Well, he came from the corner. He had been knocked down. He came from the corner. Here he is right here with the redirection. They kind of, the defense at Dartmouth kind of forgot about him. And he was able to go uncontested to the net and get a stick on it. Good response here by RPI.
Dumped in by the big green. 1-1 game. 6.5 minutes in. Nice catch of the line. Pierce fires one in. That one out of play. And we get a face-off coming up here. So Gagne with his first
RPI collision. Goal was scored by from 27.
Point Claire Quebec. Wellington Duke is playing just his 13th game.
He was assisted by number 26, Shane Seller. And by number 23, Jake Johnson.
So maybe Seller picks
goal,
up an assist there.
17 seconds.
He's on his way to another four
RPI
assist game in this building.
27, Gagno,
for the engineers.
First of the season.
Would that
first
be some way to
kind
of
from
cap
26,
his
Seller.
Collegiate
and
career?
23,
of course, season not over yet.
At 6:17.
It would be an interesting stat line, storyline.
RPI Athletics.
Seller could have a big game here against his former team.
After the whistle.
For your cooperation.
He actually had 6 points in that game when he had the four assists. He also had 2 goals against RPI.
Veteran Chip McDonald talking to the guys.
Yeah, we haven't seen Chip in a while.
Chip is in. I think this will be his last year. I was talking to him before the game. 30 years as an ECAC official. Maybe not an ECAC, well, yeah.
Maybe, or just as a college hockey official?
Yeah.
Maybe the whole time. Here's 30 shot, that's good block. Now by Sorkin. And now we got a whistle here. And they're saying Mashey, I guess, was in the crease.
Yep.
So, send the face off outside the zone.
Yeah, you know what? Come to think of it, I think this is Chip's first game here. I don't think some of the RPI players know Chip, but they'll certainly get an introduction. One of the good ones.
This will be not cleared. Locke keeps it at the line. Behind the goal they go. Chipped off the glass and back down ice here. Beat out the icing. Nice speed there, shown by the freshman from Sweden, Trum Lokeberg. Right back down the other way. Lokeberg to center. Another whistle here.
That was icing.
Another icing.
Good look at Seller.
Cover here for Watson. Watson. That'll be cleared to center, although Mashy didn't know a lot about it. Dump back in by Markell. And now Lee. To center, Dubinsky will shoot this in. Lee, Mashy, Dubinsky trying to give it back to Mashy, and it's broken up. Townley to center, Townley all the way in. Townley a shot, he scores! Right over the right shoulder.
Wow, looked like that was going to be
the left shoulder, I guess.
Yeah.
Watson, yeah.
Excuse me. Right over the glove hand. I mean, he really didn't have much to shoot at. It was the end of his shift. Right hand shot. They let him get out pretty. I mean, they didn't take that space away from him. I think that was a mix up between the two defensemen.
Yeah.
Giving them some space there through the neutral zone.
So Dartmouth retakes the lead here. Agnew sent to an open wing. Baxter trying to get there, but beaten to it by Palisic.
He was assisted by number 17, Braden Dorfman.
Steve Townley picking up his third goal of the season.
Number 2, Harrison Markle.
And there's a glove save by Watson.
Time of that goal, 8 minutes.
Steve's from
44
Woodstock,
seconds.
Vermont. Played locally with the CP Dynamo, Brad Shaver, and then went and played the New Jersey
Markle
Hitmen.
At 8:44.
Coach Toby Harris. Did a few hockey schools with Toby up in Exeter, New Hampshire, at the Phil Section School. Coaching in that Premier League for a long time for the Hitmen. Excellent coach. As is Brad Shaver.
And that was Linden gets dumped as he moved his way into the zone. Fans are hollering for potential penalty. No arm goes up. Now Baxter a shot, and that one goes wide. Leppinen was in the vicinity trying to get a tip on it.
Yeah, he was in the goaltender Stevenson's face. I don't think Stevenson saw that at all.
Linden shot sticked away. Laka looking to score from a tight angle there, but so Stevenson not having any of that. We'll glove it and get a whistle.
Good look at Stevenson. Fort Coquitlam, British Columbia. He played well for the Big Green this year.
Dartmouth tried to break to center. We apologize for any audio issues you might be having at home. We're not sure what the issue is, but folks are working on it. Hoping at least you can see what's going on, which I guess is the most important thing. Secondary, probably. 30. Gonna get his, or excuse me, Klee gonna get a stick to that. Now Surdy. Picking up speed to the neutral zone. He'll chip it in before taking a bump there from Palisic. Dubinsky up the boards. Lee. Hops off his stick for a second. He'll turn and shoot. That's blocked by Palisic. Dubinsky cycling. Nobody home on the other side. Johnson will pinch down, but he gets bumped. Lee keeps it in at the blue line. Dubinsky, touch pass in front, looking for Johnson. Well defended again by Palisic, who's been all over the place so far. Now he gets taken down. Dubinsky lost his glove. He's able to pick that up. And now skated out there by Cameron. He has the first goal of the game for the Big Green. Dumps it Johnson shoots it in. Adamo runs through his skates. It'll be carried out. Waters dumping it in. Walsh, a pass backwards. Shelburne has to go to the corner to get it. Baxter for Walsh. Beaten. John Beaton behind the goal, sends it back to the point. Shelburne, wrist shot coming, takes a deflection. And the deflection really took all the sting out of the shot. Came spinning in on Stevenson, who covers up for a whistle. 7:43 to go. We got a media timeout here. With Dartmouth leading it 2-1.
Yeah, nice low shot from the point. Adamo trying to get a stick on it, but it was being lifted by Borsch of the big green. So Adamo, here's another look at it. Borsch has a stick of Adamo. He couldn't get it on the ice. Stevenson makes a save. Good look at Stevenson. Good size, 6'4", 185. Nice that Coach Weber was home for this snowfall this weekend. We didn't have to snow blow his driveway.
He didn't snow blow your driveway?
No.
Or you wanted to just do it?
No.
No. Shots are 6-4 RPI, but they trail 2-1. Ready to restart play here. Puck out to center ice. Face-offs in favor of Dartmouth so far, 14-8. Kessler. Played around behind. Pierce. For Musa, and now Markell. Bumping in. Shelbert. Laka just lobbing it ahead. Linden had it for a moment, but it was knocked away. Joey Musa dumps it back in, sophomore from Orange Park, Florida. Through the middle, Laka, line backhand pass, Gallant picks that off. Poked away by Laka, but carried on further by Palisic. Shot blocked, as that was Lacerdo. Now Baxter. Roughing up Gallant. Chipped up the wall, Dubinsky going to try and get on the end, he will. Flips it in deeper as RPI changes. Lacerdo partially avoids the hit from Surdy, but it's chipped back down ice. Race for the puck here. Klee's got to get on his horse, and he just barely beats Lokeberg to the puck. Big green dump in. Watson hands it off for Surdy. Runs into Lokeberg, and now Klee. Center ice. Dubinsky does a nice job not to take a penalty there. He was kind of on the wrong side of his man, but he
did give a little bit of a hook.
Yeah, a little bit, right. Yeah. I'm saying he did a nice job to avoid.
Exactly, yeah.
Taking the call there. Just kind of walking that thin line.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen those go the other way this year.
Here's Walsh, wrist shot, glove save. I got a trivia question coming up here in a little bit, Coach, just to spice some things
up. If you can't make it to a home game,
we might do it in the second period.
RPI,
if we're still having, we might still be having audio issues, so I don't want to ask a trivia question no one can hear. I think it's an overall problem with our audio going out. I have folks out on the ground. We're chiming in. Maybe it's been fixed. I don't know. But I'll still ask in the second period. 2-1, Dartmouth leads. 5.5 to go first period. Markell shoots it around, but it hops off the wall. Kind of funny.
Like, good thing he had some zip on that. That would have been dangerous.
Right. RPI might have had numbers in the offensive zone.
Oh, they definitely would have.
Waters. Shot blocked again. Markell, we got a penalty coming up. High stick is the call. Is it on Dartmouth? I don't think RPI touched the puck. Well, it's a good thing it is. Then a good thing they blew it dead because Stevenson was headed to the bench.
Yeah. A bit of a mix-up there.
Yeah. Josh Waters is pleading his case. He said he was shooting the puck and then his follow-through must have come up, but it's not going to matter. In the eyes of the officials here, power play for the Engineers. Comes in at 16.2% on the season.
Dartmouth penalty to number 18, Josh Waters.
Dartmouth PK.
He receives 2 minutes for a stand.
Baxter's going to walk this in.
14 minutes,
as it knocked away.
18 of Dartmouth, Waters.
86% of the power for the PK for Dartmouth. Baxter fires
the ball. It's an East Stewart, Jones, Hacker-Murphy power play for RPI.
Not terrible.
No, that's, I mean, that's kind of where you want to be, maybe a little higher than that. RPI moves it back to the point. Shelbert, backdoor Baxter, sent back across. Might have been deflected. It's going to be cleared down by Nate Morgan, the freshman from Calgary.
Good defensive play by Nate, having that stick in the passing lane. They tried to go across to the back door.
Nice move into the zone. Linden, a shot and a save by Stevenson. Good chance there for the Engineers. Kind of a rush play on the power play. You don't see a ton of that. It's usually the PK is ready to get set up, but two are broken into the zone with some space.
Yeah, well, it looked like their defenseman, Borsch, wasn't in the middle of the ice. He got caught more towards the puck, which left that open.
Walsh directly makes a move. A little saucer pass across, and that tipped away from Lockett at the most opportune moment if you're on the PK. Now Johnson. Lapinen. Far side, Rister, and that missed high and wide from Linden, who was looking to pick up the top corner. It'll leave the zone. A couple of good looks on this power play so far for RPI. 20 seconds left on it. Cleared down the glass and all the way. Watson out of his net to play. Seller skating ahead with Gagneau. Has the lone RPI goal so far, his first collegiate tally. Right back behind the net.
Dartmouth returns to full strength.
Kalasic. Musa dumping in. Watson. A little hairy there for a moment, but able to get back into position. Puck in the corner.
Yeah, he kind of lost the handle on that one. I think he didn't know what to do because he had a Dartmouth green coming from both sides.
Puck played into the middle, but quickly swatted away by Surdy. Kept in at the line, on goal. Watson has to make a save. It looked more like just kind of a play to keep it in, but it wound up on goal. Now it'll be dumped down by the Engineers. Going to be icing here.
Yeah, Gallant was all alone there behind the defenseman.
is sent down ice. Not enough for icing. Pierce going to shoot it around. Turned around quickly with Lee. Mashey going to the front of the net, but Lee couldn't find him. And now Mashey again. Lee, a backhander on goal, and again, Stevenson in good position to make the save.
Oh, they just like to get that puck to the net, hopefully create a rebound, and go to the net looking for that rebound, but Stevenson hold on to that for the faceoff.
Snapped ahead. This is Sorkin. Sorkin. Minute 17 to go in the period. Lee. Cross ice pass. Too far out in front of Mashu. I think was trying to get it changed.
Yeah, Lepinen.
Didn't have any more.
Real good discipline by Lepinen.
Wait, yeah.
This is the final minute of play in the period. Last minute of play.
Hessler with a big hit on the far side on Agnew. Now Linden. Circle. Kjellberg shot, club save. Didn't hold it. It'll be cleared out. Stevenson. Just got enough of it with his glove there.
Good job by Kjellberg.
Laka, Lepinen trying to give it back to him. And maybe Ottavila should have shot the puck there.
Oh, yeah.
Stevenson was looking the wrong way. He almost didn't have time to react to that extra pass. He was still looking at the first one.
Tell you what, I wouldn't have expected that puck back to Otto.
Ottavila, he is pretty unselfish, and he showed it there. But, yeah, he's got to just bang that one in. Trying to give it back to Laka for the highlight reel goal. Goal. 10.3 seconds left in the period. Shots are 10-5 RPI, but Dartmouth leads this one 2-1.
Especially with Dad in the stands. Otto, put that back of the net.
Adamo. Agnew with one, and that'll do it for the opening period. Dartmouth scored first and most recently. They lead RPI 2-1 after one. We'll hopefully have this, whatever kind of audio problem we're having, squared away when we start the second period. Then we can get to my trivia question for all the folks watching and for Coach. But until then, Coach, thoughts here on the opening frame.
I thought it was a good period. You know, both shots by Dartmouth. No, really, not much to watch it do on it.
A real good play
by RPI to get the equalizer right after that. But good period of hockey. They're down by one, but lots of hockey to be played.
All right, we'll be back with the second period in just a bit. You're watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.
Ryan Twake, 403. The RPI pep band. Boucher Financial Group has been serving their clients for over 27 years with offices in historic downtown Troy and Saratoga Springs. They currently manage over $400 million in assets, and they act as their client's personal CFO for any financial decisions. Visit boucherfinancial.com to learn more. RPI Hockey would like to thank GE, Moe's, Sefcu, CDPHP, Boucher and Clark Financial Group, Yankee Trails, Nigro Companies, Red Front Pizza, Tri-City Rentals, Ben and Jerry's, Warren W. Fain, CDTA, Boucher and Clark Benefits, Jolene Morris of Howard Hanna Real Estate Services, Wicked Smart, BSN Sports, and Tri-City Valley Cats, all proud sponsors of RPI Hockey. RPI would like to thank Rensselaer Alumni Association, Patterson, Sampson, Ginsburg, and Griffin Law Firm, Rensselaer Dining Services, the Hilton Garden Inn, Troy, National Grid Foundation, the Desmond Hotel Crown Plaza, the Recovery Sports Grill, E. Stewart Jones Hacker Murphy Law Firm, Stewart's Shops, Stanley Steamer, Gatherers Granola, Rensselaer Honda, and Repeat Business Systems, all proud sponsors of RPI Athletics. Change in the scoring on the first Dartmouth goal. The goal was scored by number 7, Jack Cameron. The assist goes to number 6, Tanner Pelosic. Time of that goal was 4:27.
Second period about to get underway. RPI trailing Dartmouth 2-1. Perilous Harris here with Dan Fridgen, former RPI men's hockey coach. And Fridge, it's a little bit chilly here. We got a snowstorm we're dealing with. And we got senior day tomorrow. A lot going on this weekend.
Yes. Senior day tomorrow, yeah. Did a good job around campus planning out.
Yeah. You're able to drive up here fine?
No problems at all.
You could have walked.
Yeah, I could have. Ain't happening.
No, not even, you didn't put your big boots on anyway?
I got boots on.
Okay.
Not the big ones.
Not the big boots.
How about some out-of-town scores?
Yeah, give it to me.
After one period, Yale's up 1-0 on Clarkson.
Okay.
Princeton up 1-0 on Colgate.
Interesting.
Cornell up 1-0 on Quinnipiac.
Okay.
Brown up 1-0 on St. Lawrence. And Harvard and Union are tied at 1.
Okay. Well, one of those results is good for RPI to move up. Of course, all this is based on RPI winning 2 games this weekend. They have to do that. But also the Colgate, they need Colgate to lose and they need Cornell to lose a lot. Anyway, 10 seconds in, and we have an icing call here against RPI. Here's Pierce off the draw, sending it across to the far point for Markell. It'll hop off the end wall and it'll be covered by Watson.
That was Hessler that went to the bench to get a stick, but the whistle blew, so he figured he'd go just pick it up and get ready for the faceoff.
All right, so we've solved the audio issue, Coach, so I can ask my trivia question this period. I'm so excited.
Great.
You're definitely not, so that's okay. That's okay. Jake Johnson trying to poke it free. Dubinsky. And now Jacob Lee. Ooh, takes a nice shoulder hit there from Musa. Agnew shooting it in.
And he felt that when Lee went to the bench.
Yeah.
Holding his left shoulder.
Musa trying to tap it ahead for Sorkin, but he was headed off in a change anyway. Surdy down the middle for Adamo. And now shot in by Baxter. RPI trying to put some forecheck pressure on here. They nearly steal the puck, but Big Green able to move it ahead. Chisholm into the middle. That's intercepted. Kjellberg will start the rush the other way. Simon with a team-high 16 assists. To go along with 5 goals, he leads all RPI blue liners. 21 points on the air as Gagneau fired a shot that knocked the stick out of the hand of Cameron. Jake Gagneau has the lone RPI tally today. It's his first collegiate goal. Came in a nice redirection. Middle stages of that opening frame.
Cameron looks like he's struggling trying to get off the ice.
Yeah, maybe he got shaken up on that play where he blocked a shot and lost his stick, got knocked out of his hands. Here's Hallbauer, quick shot. That hit the shin pad of the defender. That was Townley in front. Another shot save, rebound! Oh, what a stop, are you kidding me? Stevenson absolutely robbed Seller there.
No question, that rebound went right to Seller. Take another look at it here.
Actually,
how did
he get over?
It's not Seller.
Oh, no, it wasn't. It was beaten.
Yep.
My mistake. Seller was in front. No, it wasn't even beaten. It was Gagneau.
Yeah.
He was looking for number 2. If he could have put it on net, that was headed into the middle of the crease.
Yeah, he had Seller on the other side waiting for it. I figured he was a right shot.
He's kind of flashed by. I couldn't tell who it was. It was Gagneau.
At any rate, it was a great pad save by Stevenson. Denied a goal. A second goal by Gagneau.
There was room for Gagneau to fit that in. We got an icing call. Nope. We got a cross interference.
Yeah, Hallbauer.
So Dartmouth's going to go on the power play for the first time. Go ahead, Coach.
I was just going to say he dumped the puck around Hallbauer, and Hallbauer decided to ride him off into the boards.
Interference is the call.
First power play opportunity of the game for the Big Green.
Dartmouth power play this season, 13.8%, 12 out of 87. RPI's PK, 87.7%. 107 killed and 122 penalty kill opportunities. There's a shot and a save by Watson, and the rebound just fell right into the red basket there. He's able to hold on.
Well, I don't know if that didn't get tipped down into him.
Might have been.
Nice play off the draw to set that up. Move the puck to the weak side. They had a clear shot on goal. Off the faceoff went.
This will be shot all the way down by the Engineers. From behind the goal, it's going to be Dylan Witzke, freshman from Calgary. Cleared out by Gagneau. Getting a chance for some PK minutes here. Lacerdo. Handed it off and then got it back. Locke will try to clear out to center for Beaton. And complete the job and shoot it the rest of the way down the ice. RPI 0 for 1 on the power, but this is Dartmouth's first chance. Into the zone, Dorfman. Sent back by Chisholm. Chisholm again. Roughed up by Klee. Sent back to the line. Captain Pierce quickly moves it in front. Shoots and scores. Ian Pierce with his fifth goal of the season. And it's 3-1 Dartmouth, a power play tally here.
Well, by the looks of Gallant, looks like he was coming from the corner as well. I think he's going to get a stick on this. He did. Oh, and he just right after that pointed to himself. Here he's coming to the
corner. Think it was Gallant? Yeah, I think
yep, right here. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
You're right.
Got a stick on that. Gallant now with his big green leading 10th goal of the season.
Gallant from Concord, Massachusetts. Junior picks up the power play goal.
We've had two goals scored like that tonight.
A lot of redirections. Dartmouth takes its first two-goal lead of the evening. Morgan sends it back to the line. Markell's shot deflected up into the netting and out of play. As some more
Dartmouth power play goal scored by number 11,
Ryan Lovett.
And he was assisted by
Rory Herman of RPI. Getting into a bit of a shoving match there after the play.
And by number 17, Braden Dorfman. Time of that goal, 3 minutes 48 seconds. Dartmouth goal.
We get goalie change here.
From 23, Pierce, and 17, Dorfman at 3:48.
Interesting.
Your attention, please. Now playing goal for RPI number one.
Yeah, that is a little odd, right? So Lyndon Marshall is in. Grad student from Victoria, British Columbia. Actually relieved Watson last game against Yale as well. Backdoor feed, shot save, rebound loose, it's in! I think it's going to be Tour Linden's goal as it deflected off of Dartmouth, the defender in front. If it is Linden's, it's his 15th of the season, and RPI's right back in it.
Yeah, I don't know if that was Musa. No, that was number six, Kolasic.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be Trevor Linden's goal.
And rebound just popped in there.
Yep.
Lepinen was in the vicinity, but it definitely came off of Palasek, who's been around the puck a lot today. When you're around the puck, sometimes it goes in your own goal.
Well, that's the second time tonight that RPI has responded with a goal. They did it on Dartmouth's first goal, and now they've done it on Dartmouth's third goal, responded with one of their own to keep it a one-game goal lead for the Big Green.
Back to the point. Agnew. Johnson shot right on, saved by Stevenson.
He'll RPI on. Goal was scored by number 19, Tour Linden. He was assisted by number 39, Jacob Laka. And by number 11, Arovile Lepinen. Time of the goal, 4 minutes 20 seconds. RPI's second goal scored by 19, Linden, his 15th of the season. From 39, Laka, and 11, Lepinen at 4:20.
Agnew going to shoot this in. Stopped there by Stevenson. Behind the goal. Now, Pierce. Showing pretty good stick handling skills from the blue line. He'll move it ahead. Now, fanning on the pass was Johnson. He'll go around behind for Agnew. High off the glass out to center, where it's gloved down by Borsch. Turned around by the engineers. Beaten across, and they're offside as Walsh was a little bit too excited on that far side.
He was real excited. He was well across that blue line.
He wanted to get to the net. You could tell.
When I looked up and I saw where he was compared to where the puck was, I was thinking, how did he get there?
All right, so we have a faceoff coming up here. Kjellberg will shoot it in. Puck's pinned up along the wall. Finally comes free to Linden. Chipped over the wall by Lovett. Now another chance to clear for Tyler Borsch, sophomore from Maple Grove, Minnesota. Linden, good outlet pass. It hops off the stick of Lapinen, but he'll track it down. Laka back to Lapinen. Lapinen centering pass. He was trying to find Linden. The Dartmouth net kind of raised up off the ice for a second, but stayed on its pegs. Now a jam try. Klee still trying to find it. It'll be cleared out on the carry by Lokiberg. And sent down. Good chance again for RPI there.
Yeah, they're just knocking on the doorstep.
Linden. Backhands it in. Cameron. Shielding the puck and gets it as far as center. Lifted back to neutral ice by Hallbauer. Gloved down by Herman. Has to be the next to play it. And is, so we play on. Cameron. Gets wrapped up there by Gagneau. Chipped up the boards. Hallbauer over to cut it off. He'll shoot it back up the boards. And now right back in. Hallbauer. Hands it off to Herman. Herman spins around at the point. Cross ice, shot coming in. It was Adamo who gloved it and shot it almost all in one motion. It was a good effort there.
Yeah, that was a real good play to knock that puck out of the air and take a shot off like that.
Sorkin centering, goes all the way through as sticks were tied up. Surdy got the last tie up there.
Yeah, that's a good play by Surdy.
Well, it's a couple of players and hit a player coming off the bench, I think. There were shouts for too many men. Linesmen are still pointing. I'm not sure why they blew the whistle, because I think it hit a player who was actually standing on the ice.
As future generations of student-athletes continue to receive the opportunity to balance the rigors of academics with collegiate athletics. Learn more about how...
Officials are saying he was on the bench.
Yeah,
it looked like they were both standing on the ice to me.
They were saying they were at the bench.
At the bench, okay.
Yes. Let's go. Which is Ray. Fine if they're at the bench and the puck goes in there.
Yeah.
And neither one attempted to play it.
Okay.
Now, if you come off the bench and you play it and the other guy's standing there, yeah, there's going to be a penalty.
Okay. I thought I could just hit you and still be a penalty, but I could be wrong there. I'll take your word for it. Gagneau is a try at the far post now. Walsh's shot, or Johnson, excuse me, that's blocked. Shots are 17-7 RPI. Gagneau. Johnson. Looking for Mashey, but that's blocked again. Dartmouth has numbers if they want it. Lacerdo leading ahead. And not exactly how you lead a 3-on-2 rush. Now Adamo tried to hand it off to Johnson. They're not on the same page, but RPI is going to keep possession of it here with Mashey.
Yeah, Lacerdo kind of lost the handle on that before entering the zone. He had a real good block in the defensive zone, though.
Big Green will skate it out to center. Musa ahead, Lovett. It's knocked off balance a bit by Walsh, but it'll be played by Morgan. Lokiberg. High in the air to center ice. Adamo couldn't track it down. Pierce can. Morgan into the zone for Dartmouth. That's broken up. Now Walsh the other way. Former Northeastern Husky. Turned around again by the Big Green in the neutral zone. Laka ahead for Linden. Just off the bench. Linden makes a move into the corner for Lapinen. Adovile trying to center. Hit a skate with it. Wasn't really anybody there. Lapinen again has it taken away by Townley. And now moved ahead by Dartmouth. Waters. Markell lost it. Scooped along and Townley couldn't keep the line. puck into the pants of Lapinen and out. It'll be chipped down the other way by Locke. I think this is icing. And it is. 9:48 to go in the second. 3-2 Dartmouth leads. They took a 3-1 lead briefly, but as Coach mentioned, RPI has been able to answer a couple of Dartmouth goals in this game so far.
Yeah. Lapinen didn't know that that puck had
went
into his pants. Tried to get a change there, but ref said no.
Wrist shot coming high and wide of Linden. Marshall, that is. He's into the game this period. I don't know if he's seen a shot yet. I don't think he has. At least one on goal. Got no save so far from Marshall. One timer that hits the skate of Lapinen. Laka high off the boards and out to center ice.
That Lapinen line got double shifted there. They sat down for a shift and right back out.
Could that be just something that coach is feeling there?
Yep.
You ever do that?
Yep.
Seller trying to backhand one in front. Bouncing puck goes wide. Seller again for Gagneau. Dartmouth defender is down behind the play. That's Cohen.
Dartmouth has been doing a real good job of a short little pass and clearing their zone on the breakout.
Pierce intercepts at center. Morgan will play. It's the big green trying to complete a change. Sent into the middle where it's swatted away. Herman. Poway, California. Rory Herman. High off the glass, gloved down by Pierce. He runs into trouble in the form of Seller. He gives him a bump right in front of the bench, and now they're offside, as it was Trim Lokenberg a little bit too out, far out in front there.
Hey, if you're thinking of buying or selling your home,
Dartmouth
contact Jolene
Horst a little bit,
at Howard Hanna Real Estate Services offside. At 518-331-1579.
8:06 to go, second period.
Team in Rensselaer County.
No Pat Salvis in the press box today. No longer the SID for Dartmouth men's hockey after he was for a number of years. And Nick's taking over up here. It's just not the same. We used to. There was a game a couple years ago, Coach, where I brought my Sega Genesis up here and we played NHL 94 on the scoreboard.
Really?
Yeah, when Pat showed up. So yeah, we've had some fun with Pat throughout the years, and he did a great job with the big green and their Twitter handle. Almost made them famous specifically because of how he was able to work a Twitter account. But big green men's hockey in capable hands with Nick, who I've been talking to, been for the first time in person. We've had some meetings over Zoom, but. And just having some fun with it. I didn't ask Nick if he was a fan of NHL 94. Maybe I should have next time. We could have gotten a game on the Jumbotron before the game, but maybe next time. I'll get to my trivia question soon. I keep teasing it, but next stoppage I'll ask you and see if you can answer. I'll give the folks at home a chance to answer, too.
Well, Mike DeRocher, I talked to him before the game. He's the athletic trainer.
Yeah.
15 seasons. But
okay.
Only his second with hockey. He was football before that.
Okay, that's got to be an interesting transition.
I said to him, I said, yeah, you probably have a lot more fun with the hockey guys, aren't you? And he's like, yeah.
Dubinsky into the zone. Trying to center for Baxter. And then Hashi throws a hit at center ice. Sent in by Adamo.
That could have been interference.
Yeah, Chris Thompson, CT, he was the hockey. The Lapinen fires high off the glass, and that's going to go out of play. Chris Thompson was the hockey contact for a while. Now he takes care of, he's the head trainer now with the, takes over football. So similar, kind of a reverse move there.
Yeah, exactly.
Because Ort, obviously Ort was the head trainer.
Yes. Yep.
When you were here, I'm sure.
Yes, he was, and Chris was the assistant.
Right.
Ort retired.
He's in the Hall of Fame now. RPI Athletics Hall of Fame. A few years ago. Quick shot there, Linden, and a save by Stevenson.
That was a set play right off the draw.
Tour looking for number two. They nearly had it. Linden again makes a move. Lampin in, fires it wide. Laka flying in on the back door. This top line has been as advertised for RPI so far tonight.
Yeah, they have.
Creating a goal. And just more than that, just creating all kinds of problems every time they're on the ice. Linden trying to jump on this. It was poked away. Pierce is going to get there first.
Good speed by Pierce there.
Yeah. Loose in the zone. Linden just kind of waiting for it in front of the net, see if he could get to him. Tour again. Backhands it back to the point, but that doesn't quite get there. Sorkin. Ryan Sorkin will dump in. Under 7 to go in the second period. 3-2 is the Dartmouth lead. Good hit there on Gagneau at center. Herman ahead. Backhanded in by Seller.
Gagneau's offside.
Yep. Surdy even being caught up ice there a little bit. And now a play broken up. Gagneau trying to skate off without the puck. Unfortunately, he might have been gone if he had picked it up.
He would have been gone, no question.
Seller, he has an assist tonight against his former team. He'll dump it high in the air and down the ice, but not enough on it for icing, played by Palasek. Palasek trying to go coast to coast, and that's cut off in a hurry once he entered the RPI zone. Now Seller. Fired down. He was on the right side of the red line here, so no icing. Walsh trying to cycle for Herman. Herman right out in front, all the way through. Baxter, a shot saved by Sorensen, or by Stevenson, excuse me. Palasek. Love it. Wrapped around. Braden Dorfman can't clear the zone. Baxter wrist shot, that's blocked to center. And Simon Kjellberg will be the first one to it. New York Rangers draft pick just sends it out to center ice. Took a couple of deflections, and Gallant will carry it back in for the big green.
Nice block by Lokiberg.
Rister comes all the way through from the point. That was the captain, Markell. And now Kjellberg. Gets some pressure, but finds Gagneau. Jake Gagneau to center. Too far out in front of Adamo, and Markell will turn it around quickly. Now, avoiding a check there was Gallant, just going down to the ice. That's one way to do it. Shot wide from Dubinsky. He saw that train coming, and he said, I don't want any part of this, and just kind of laid down.
It's called a bail.
Jake Johnson will pick it up with time and space in his own zone. Zips it ahead to center for Laka. Laka drop past Dubinsky. Circle, shot goes wide. Agnew fires it through with Mashey trying to steer it home. Dubinsky pulls up at the blue line. Had it knocked away. He was trying to feed it back to Agnew. And now a chance to rush up for Chisel. Sorkin going to the net. Gets a redirection. It goes wide. Well-timed play on that one. Now a try from Borsch goes wide. Hits that spot on the half wall on the far side. That's caused some problems already today. And then Agnew puts one right into the skates. Alaka knocks him down. Friendly fire there. As RPI, I think I said, no, Lepinen beats it out. In front, Walsh, a shot right on. Saved by Stevenson.
Well, Lepinen was wide open on the back door, too.
It'll be cleared out, but again, not enough on this for icing as Hallbauer will play. Linden avoids a hit, stays on the puck. Wide for Walsh. Walsh returning it in front, and it goes behind the goal. Linden trying to center again. Swept out of danger by Musa. And now Borsch. Tyler Borsch, sophomore from Maple Grove, Minnesota. Working it ahead. Backhand shot saved by Marshall. Really the first time he's been tested at all in this period after coming on in replace of Watson. And we get a hand pass. We'll Stop play, 2:39 to go in the second, 3-2 Dartmouth. Chances at both ends here after RPI pulled it within 3-2, but we've been kind of been in a stalemate since then.
Yeah, when Dartmouth gets the opportunity, RPI's been putting on real good forecheck of pressure. Here's another look at that. He just gets a stick on it. Marshall ended, enabled himself to close that five hole.
Gagno feeding it up the wall for Seller. Herman, no. Cameron scored the first goal of the game tonight. His third on the year. Tip deep by Herman, race for the puck. Tonley going to be the first one to it, but he's met in a hurry by Seller. Seller gives him a shove. Back to the point. Schoberg has it lost in his skates, but feeds it off for Seller. Now it's cleared down. Could be icing here if the Engineers win the race, and they will. Here's your question, Coach. RPI has had two second-round draft choices in the NHL entry draft in the history of the hockey program here. Can you name the second-round picks? We've never had a first-round pick play for RPI, but two second-rounders have played for the Engineers. Can you name them? I'll give you a little bit of time. Don't say it right away if you know, because I want to get the viewers a chance as well.
Yep.
We'll revisit it in a second. Who are the only two second-round draft picks in RPI hockey history? There's going to be a puck sent down. Beating out the icing is Morgan, unless he got a touch on it already anyway. Johnson. Beaten. Back for Walsh. Walsh trying to give it back to Beaton, back to Walsh. Quick shot, got blocked. Adamo, a backhander, and that stopped there by the left pad of Stevenson.
Good play by Adamo. Going to his backhand there since the forehand was cut off.
Plus, he loves his backhand, as we've discussed. Markell inside, redirected wide.
This is the final minute of play in the period.
Had a man
last
in front.
Minute
that was
of
Lusardo.
Play, and it's the most minute of the game.
Lusardo.
On your feet makes the noise with the Engineers score in the final minute of this period. Fans receive a free
by
taco
beat.
At Moe's at RPI in Troy.
Get a whistle here in an icing.
The Moe's minute of the game.
RPI has outshot Dartmouth here 20-8 so far. But the Big Green continue to lead. RPI fans are on their feet. They want free food. If RPI can score a goal in the final 44.8.
I tell you right now, a couple of those guys out there for RPI look gassed.
Yeah?
Yep.
I thought you were going to say a couple guys out there look like they want tacos, but.
No.
I guess it could be both. We got a whistle here, and was that a hand pass? Let's see.
No, I think that's going to be on Johnson for interference.
Okay. I didn't see that. Yep, we got a call here.
He didn't.
I didn't see a hand go up or an arm.
Neither did I, but I watched Johnson.
Yeah, you're right.
He didn't play the puck at all. He just prevented the guy from getting access to the puck.
So Johnson's going to go off here for interference. Second power play chance for Dartmouth. They're 1-for-1 so far.
RPI, I think part of the reason why he did it like that was because he was one of the guys I was referring to as to being gassed.
Time of that penalty,
yeah,
19 minutes,
that could, yeah, that could contribute. You're right, for sure.
23 of
so this power play, RPI hopes will carry over to the 19-20. Third. 32 seconds to go in the frame. Pierce a shot, save Marshall. Rebound still loose, and Lapinen's going to pick it up and clear. So I've already changed that goal to Mark Gallant, who did the redirection, as Coach mentioned, from Dorfman and Pierce. That was the most recent Dartmouth goal. RPI then pulled back to within a single goal as Tuur Linden scored from Laka and Lepinen. Now shorthanded, maybe. Seller is going to shoot it down with one. And that'll do it for the second period of play. Dartmouth continuing to lead RPI here despite the shot disparity, 20-9 Engineers. RPI also winning the faceoff battle 27-19, so they've turned that around in a hurry. And really, the difference in this game right now is that power play goal that Dartmouth scored.
Yep, yeah. They've got, as you mentioned, two deflected goals. And Coach Smith decided to make a goaltender change, and I think maybe two shots on goal for Marshall.
Yeah, so, yeah, not a lot seen, but that's really how this game has gone. Chances have come. RPI will hope to pick up a tying goal, maybe a go-ahead goal in the final period. We will step aside here and be back with more from the Houston Fieldhouse. Your score after two is Dartmouth 3 and the Engineers 2. You're watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.
Or visit online at yankeetrails.com. the RPI Pep Band. Hey, remember, Ben & Jerry's is located in the Student Union. Don't forget, stop by, grab your favorite flavor from cow to cone. Enjoy your scoop. Ben & Jerry's is proud to support RPI Hockey.
Thank you.
All right, third period of play about to get underway. We have a minute 21 of power play time left for the Dartmouth Big Green. And here we go. Dartmouth on its second power play of the game as Pierce will drop it back. And Gallant moving it in. Backhand shot in the left pad saved by Marshall. Penalty coming up on Chisholm. So just like that, the power play is over as Seller was tripped. We'll play 4-on-4 for a bit.
Great left pad save there by Marshall. And it looked like he stepped on his stick, but either way, it's
That'll work. Of course, Chisholm never played with number 15, Seller.
Sean Chisholm. He receives 2 minutes
he's
for
just a freshman. Lapinen tried to win that faceoff forward, ended up peeling it back anyway, although now it'll leave the zone.
Number 15, Chisholm of Dartmouth.
RPI continues to
at 15 seconds.
Win draws, 28 faceoff wins to 20. Now a nice move by Linden inside. He had 30, but they're offside. A couple times tonight that the engineers have broken with a lot of speed only to be ruled offside.
Out of town scores, Yale and Clarkson are tied at 1-2. Colgate-Princeton tied at 2-2. Yep. Cornell up on Quinnipiac 1-0 after 2. Brown up 1-0 on St. Lawrence. Yep. And Harvard and Union are tied at 2.
Cornell looking like they're going to wrap up the four spot there. Now Lapinen a shot and a save. Second try, Lapinen no. It'll be worked out there. Now a shorthanded chance maybe. No, we're still 4-on-4. I'm not sure I got ahead of myself there. Fired wide. Lacerdo thought about another shot but then plays it back. Palasik just dumps it in. 8 seconds away from an RPI power play.
Lapinen was headed
RPI
off, but he was told to stay
strength.
On, but now he's going off. If
now the power play begins for the Engineers.
Packer Murphy power play for the Engineers.
Less than a minute on that. That was kept in by Chelberg. Baxter, wrist shot, redirected save. The rebound just sits at the top of the crease. It'll be cleared out. Great chance there for the Engineers. It was a good tip. I think that was Mashey.
Yeah, good pad save by Stevenson. Almost got away on him.
Yeah, just kind of sat there. No one could reach it. Dubinsky. Markell. He's wrapped up. Kicked up the half wall for Baxter. Baxter to the point. Chelberg. Chelberg a shot right on. Stevenson again. Right in the midsection there. He's able to hold on.
Yep, no rebound. And Adamo right in front of the net. Taking the eyes away of Stevenson. Not sure Stevenson saw it, but he was down in his butterfly. Another look at it. A wicked wrister. Twisted wrister.
Big Green win the draw. Markell, 5 to go in the power play. And it's shot all the way down. So RPI 0 for 2
Dartmouth returns
on the man
to
advantage
strength.
Here today. Johnson ahead. Agnew gets it back, throws one towards goal. And it goes behind the net. Couple engineers had cracks at it. Herman was there along with Seller.
Surprise, Seller's there.
Now a giveaway. Gagneau. Turns and shoots one, right pad save. Penalty coming up again. Who's it on?
That's going to be on Herman for interference. The puck got into Chip Skates. And almost a turnover.
Yeah, Herman is going off for interference. And so just after back-to-back power plays each way. The Big Green will go right back on the man advantage here. This is their third chance.
Look at it.
Yeah.
C-16.
Oh, yeah.
Bang.
Yeah, Gagneau has the puck
RPI
there. You can't hit the guy.
To number 16, Rory
Certainly
Herman.
Not.
He receives 2 minutes for interference. Time of that penalty, 2 minutes, 44 seconds.
No.
16 of RPI Herman for interference at 2:44.
Hessler, back to the point, Palasek. He'll get it back again. Fed to the circle, Sorkin. Shot was blocked by Hallbauer. He'll lift it high in the air out to center. Witski had it poked away momentarily by Beaton, who's the lone engineer forechecker here shorthanded. Still causing problems is John Beaton, the Stittsville, Ontario native. Palasek. Back out to center it goes. Laka now shorthanded. He'll take a shot, deflected off the glass. It'll stay on the ice. Linden goes backwards with it.
Laka was looking over to see who was coming on the ice.
Surdy. Agnew, former Boston College Eagle. Jack Agnew ahead for Linden. With Lappinen shorthanded. Lappinen backhand deflected up high. And what happened here?
Offside, maybe?
Oh, they're offside. I guess they're offside, yeah. I didn't hear a whistle.
Neither did I. They just quit playing, so they did.
Yeah, I guess so. The play carried on a little bit longer than I thought for a delayed offside whistle, but what do I know? Lappinen's going to take this draw. RPS had more of the puck possession here on this Dartmouth power play. Stevenson will leave it aside. Pierce. Shots are 26-10 engineers. Now Chisholm around the net. Hands that off for Dorfman. That one slips through the stick of Musa. Who can find it? Linden can. And able to clear it out to neutral ice. 12 seconds to go on the Dartmouth power play, which has been rather uneventful, at least at the offensive zone for the Big Green. Pierce from Edgewater, New Jersey, works
RPI
it out, and it'll be
strength.
Adamo. And the Frenchman will chip it off the wall, trying to get to it himself, almost reached it again. Now it's played back out to center, where Klee shoots it back in. Pierce goes behind for Cohane. And now that's Lokeberg. Baxter through the legs of Walsh. Cohane clears it. Morgan. Love it. Yeah, that could be interference there, and it's going to be. As Lokeberg just ran into the RPI defender at the blue line. Linden's on his way off here, and Baxter has to be careful.
Oh, yeah.
Moving back towards his own goal with an empty net. They're going to blow this one dead.
There are some coaches that will not pull the goaltender while the puck is in their end.
Right.
For that reason. Well, so, I don't think we're yet to play this period 5-on-5.
doesn't seem like we have. Now, Lokeberg, I'm not sure he knew too much about that RPI defender at the blue line. I think it was a bit of a sneaky play, just kind of getting his way.
Penalty to number 27,
counts,
Grim Lokeberg.
The penalty just the
he
same. That one hit the post.
2 minutes for
Lappinen hit the outside
time
of the net at least. Now Johnson.
38 seconds. 27 of Dartmouth.
Trying to pass that again.
Yeah, but he hit the goal with it. Now shorthanded Morgan, Jake Johnson, the only man back, and he does enough
Stuart
to disrupt.
Jones, Hacker Murphy, power play for the engineers.
Jake Johnson. Lappinen. Everyone waiting at the blue line. It's backhanded in by Laka. And a good hit by Johnson, but Musa will keep on trucking. At least he slowed him up enough where Laka is able to get to it easily. And now Laka will start the power play breakout over again. It's Chelberg, the Nashville, Tennessee native. Son of former NHLer Patrick Chelberg. Mashey into the circle. Puck still loose. No whistle. Dubinsky went flying in but couldn't get a stick on it. Kjellberg again down low for Dubinsky. Another former NHL son. There's a shot comes in. Glove by Stevenson. Might have been headed wide, but Adamo lurking. It was important that he saw that at all.
Yeah, Adamo's trying to get in the goaltender's face, but Stevenson just stepped around behind him, shifted over, and saw the puck coming in and gloved it for the faceoff.
13:03 to go in the third. Dartmouth still leading this one 3-2. They've never trailed in this game. Clearing effort there from Cameron. Unsuccessful. Now it's in front. Turning. Mashey fires it wide. And it'll be cleared out. 30 seconds to go on the RPI power play. It's their third of the game. Both teams with three power plays in this one so far as Lyndon Marshall leaves it aside. Sent down the middle. Deflects. Markell into the corner. Goes down. It'll wrap around for Kjellberg. And now Mashey. Cross ice feed, hits off the boards. Dubinsky, a shot, save, rebound, slapped home! It's a power play goal for Justin Adamo. We're tied at three.
And that's why he's in front of the net. He had one hand on his stick trying to fend off the defender from Dartmouth. One hand on the stick to put that puck behind Stevenson. Here's another look at it. There's a shot, that goes off the post. One hand, bang, and it's in.
Dubinsky just one-timed that puck that came off the boards.
Cameron had the body, but there's a good lesson for all you youth hockey players. You gotta somehow get the stick.
That one caught the
RPI's
shoulder of Stevenson, the Dubinsky
shot. Goal was scored by number 22, Justin Adamo.
Adamo just swept it
he
in.
He was assisted by number 14, Zach Dubinsky. And by number 25, Ryan Mashey. Time of the tying goal, 7 minutes, 33 seconds.
So we're
RPI
tied up.
Goal, 22, Adamo. His ninth of the
season. First time since it was 1-1.
From
30,
14, Dubinsky.
Hit a skate with the shot.
And 25, Mashey at 7:33.
Now Gallant out to neutral ice. Dumped in, helped aside by Marshall. 30 now. Hands it off. Seller trying to look ahead pass for Laka, but that was intercepted. And now Seller again. So both teams are 1-for-3 on the power play now. Laka trying to step through a check of Pierce. It was somewhat legal, I guess, all the way. Dorfman. Johnson leaves it on the wall for Tuur Linden, and the captain will move it ahead.
Good defensive play there because Pierce, Ian Pierce, a defenseman for Dartmouth, going down the back door.
Johnson, a shot, ricochets off the stick of a defender. Well, actually, might have been Waters who was cutting across there to force it wide of goal. Markell high in the air to center. Johnson ahead. Linden with Adamo. And now Adamo driving the net. Try to move to his backhand, and it was knocked away and cleared down the ice. This could be icing, and it will be.
RPI men's
hockey
hosts
we'll get to
Harvard University tomorrow
the answer,
night.
The late answer to the trivia question. Coach, do you think you know
the
two second-round draft picks in RPI hockey history?
I do. I know one for sure.
See
right?
Tomorrow night.
Early.
Yes, that's right.
And he was picked
drafted by the
in the 52nd round.
Tomorrow night.
52nd all
overall.
Yep. Second round
by
Pittsburgh.
Who? Yep. Okay.
However, the second one.
This is a tougher one for you.
Yeah, I know. It's not Jerry DiMigo.
It is not.
That would be the wrong answer.
But you're
Brandon Peary.
Brandon
would be
Peary. Yes, you're right.
Right answer, and I don't remember who he was drafted by.
Oh, do you have a guess?
Chicago.
Yes, that's right. Coach, you're 1-for-1. We got a penalty coming up here. Gonna go on Dartmouth. And RPI is going back in the power play. It's going to be a hook. We should just retire the trivia question game now, Coach.
Yes,
you're 1-for-1.
Done.
You're
don't
done. You're done. Okay, I'll ask you one tomorrow.
This is for the fans only.
Oh, okay. I'm going to ask you one tomorrow, too, now, so you can
All
keep
right.
your streak alive.
All right.
It was a good warm. It could have been tough, right? I think if you didn't recruit one, it would have been tougher.
Yeah, it would have been.
Yeah.
I knew it was either. I knew it was the between D'Amigo and Peary, but yeah. I didn't remember.
Yeah. I think D'Amigo was a
Dartmouth free agent, number 22.
He wasn't drafted. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought for some reason he was a Maple Leafs pick.
Time and
they got their helmets stuck together. Can we get a whistle here?
They're not.
22 yeah. Wrestler Dartmouth on a
exchanging phone. They are not exchanging phone numbers.
Denise Stewart Jones, Hacker Murphy, power play for RPI.
That's the second time this year that's happened, right? Didn't Herman get his face mask caught up with somebody this year? I think so. I'm going to stick with that. The second time it's happened. It's not in the notes, but I'm pretty sure that's the second time it's happened. You gotta be pretty tall to get your face mask stuck to Adamo's.
Yeah.
It was actually Towney and Adamo who were on that last face-off, and they got stuck together because of it. So there you go. That's a true face-off right there, right?
Yeah.
Baxter across. One-timer! Oh, and Adamo hammered it wide. Another shot by Baxter. That caroms to the middle of the ice, and it'll be cleared out there by Stephen Townley.
Wow, that didn't miss by much.
Freshman from Woodstock, Vermont, is Townley. 2 goals and 2 assists on the year for him on this penalty kill unit. Now he's off the ice as the second group is on. Clearing attempt all the way down from Musa. This is RPI's 4th power play try. They're 1-for-3. They scored on their most recent chance. They're out shooting the Big Green 30-10 here.
And believe it or not, we're tied at 3.
Yeah. Because why not? Johnson drops it off. Lepinen. Walsh trying to give it back to Lepinen. And Otto Ville will work it back to the point for Johnson. Walsh. Lepinen in front. One-timer, they score! Tuur Linden on the power play. It's his second goal of the game, 16th of the year. And that's his 30th point on the season. The first 30-point score for RPI since Riley Bourbonnais.
Well, that was just real good puck movement on behalf of RPI. Get it back to the point. Johnson down to the half wall. Walsh out to Linden. I mean, that's tic-tac-toe. Not like they've practiced that before.
RPI.
It's not quite a one-timer. It's kind of a catch and shoot if you're righty on that side, but it works out just the same.
Was scored by number 19, Tuur Linden.
Well, Dartmouth has kind of shot themselves.
He was assisted by number 11, Adovile Lepinen.
They're going to capitalize on that power play.
And by number 13,
two power play goals now for RPI. The 2-for-4, Johnson. RPI still in the attack because that one
Stewart, Jones,
popped
Hacker,
in the air.
It
goes into the corner. Nobody knows what it is, but Shane Seller who finds
seconds.
It.
It was scored by 19, Linden.
That one off the skate of Lacerdo. Now gloved at by Johnson. It goes into the corner.
Assisted by number 11, Lepinen.
Chisholm
and number
there.
13, Walsh.
Back to the point.
11-12.
As Cohane's shot was blocked. And now Seller back to center ice with it. Shane Seller on it still. Across for Herman. A shot right on and a save by Stevenson. You know, RPI could have, I don't know, maybe 4, 5, 6
National
goals
Bridge
if they
Foundation has partnered with RPI Athletics, working with local schools.
Sizable
in Troy,
Dartmouth goalie a couple more times. That was a great play by Seller, though, huh?
Yeah, that
RPI
was.
Athletics
just to get that
like
puck
thank
up.
National Grid Foundation
get a shot on
for
goal.
Their support of RPI
Terrific.
Hockey.
Looks like
our local
up
youth
some,
and local communities.
Momentum here off their power play.
It was a great reach by Seller to first send that pass across, and the reach for Herman to gather that thing. But again, if you're the goalie and the shot's coming from that close, you don't have a lot of reaction time. And RPI's had a couple of chances just like that where they're in close.
Yeah, this could be very well more than a 4-3 game if it wasn't for Stevenson, who's been playing well.
Coach Ed Dergarian says 6th-round pick of the Maple Leafs, which is actually where I was thinking.
Who?
D'Amigo.
Oh, was he? Okay.
Yeah. For some reason, I had 4th or 6th in my head, and I didn't want to.
No, that's okay.
I didn't want to call myself out. So
yeah, no, I remember now because he went to the Marlies, but I thought he was a free agent.
No, he was drafted. That's right. Binghamton kid.
Yeah, that's right. And I think what spurned Peary to go at the same time was once D'Amico decided to go, Peary said, okay.
Yeah, but I mean, that was the time for D'Amico to go, right? I mean, he was on the World Junior team. They just won gold.
I didn't think he was as ready.
No,
as
I don't think. I agree with you.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you're kind of cashing in on that.
Yeah.
The high point there. I would have loved to see them both play, you know, 2 or 3 years at least here.
Yeah.
Like Ryan Haggard, because you saw what Ryan Haggard was able to do with 3 years. Put up 40 points. I think 39. But still, here's Adamo. That NCAA team and would have been something else, right?
Definitely.
Because they went the next year.
Yeah, they had York in the pipes, right?
Yeah. But that was 10-11. Back to the point. It's kicked at. I don't want to be off of my history here. I better look it up before I get yelled at. 7 minutes to go in the game. RPI has its first lead here. Lapidin, the only engineer in the attacking zone, as his teammates change behind him. Intercepted by Linden. He'll turn and fire one on goal. Saved by Stevenson. Is now Linden's on a hat trick.
Yeah. He's trying to sniff one out.
Yeah, I'm right. 10-11. They went to Green Bay and played North Dakota and lost 6-0. But think about that team with those two guys.
Yes.
Dorfman backhands it ahead. Knocked out of the air. Baxter skates it in. Former Lowell Riverhawk shoots it around behind. Right on the front. Lockup backhand through his own legs. And Stevenson's going to find this. RPI seemingly being much more aggressive in front of the net when trying to get these pucks to the net. It's rewarded. They've been rewarded by doing so.
And they're getting to that puck to the net real fast. Look, there's no waste of time. And their sticks are free. RPI is getting their sticks free, which is allowing them to get some shots on goal. Dartmouth not doing a very good job defensively tying up sticks.
And there's a lot of still jockeying to be done as far as, you know, where the teams finish in the standings. But you, really more importantly than that is how you're playing, right, at the end of the year?
Yes, definitely.
Whether you finish fifth, sixth, seventh, it doesn't really matter. I mean, the matchups can matter at times, but at the end of the day, you got to beat who's in front of you. And I think that's the most important thing for RPI is to be playing their best hockey at the end of the year. And they've really had an up and down as far as each weekend. It seems like win-loss almost every time out.
Yeah, and I mean, if you're going to have a time when you go 50% on the power play, now's the time to do it.
That's not bad either, yeah. If you can start clicking in that department, that could win you some series.
Oh, definitely. This time of year.
RPI's had 1 3-game winning streak and one, uh-oh. Chisholm a shot. Marshall makes the save, and he's helped out there by Herman, who sweeps it into the corner. High off the glass, kept in by the glove over there of Witzke. Gallant broken up again, this time by Walsh. And now Agnew. Tip deep there by Adamo. Markell. Hip check from Beaton. Lacerdo. And now Chisholm. And they're offside. Just finishing my point. RPI has 1 3-game winning streak and 1 3-game losing streak. Other than that, they haven't lost more than two in a row or won more than two in a row all year.
Exactly. Yeah, I was looking at that. I think their last sweep of the weekend was when they played Union, November 29th, 30th.
Yeah. And the thing about it is now a breakaway chance for Linden looking for the hat trick. Oh, a right pad save by Stevenson.
Boy, he did some abracadabra there.
Linden again turns and shoots and put it right onto the tape of Cameron. And now who's the first one back checking? That's Linden again. A little bit of a jump there by Pierce at the blue line, as he was spooked by somebody. Johnson sends it to the open left side wing, where Linden turns it around and feeds it right back into Hessler. Wow. Back to Linden. Laka for Lepinen. And you know those two are trying to find Tour at any chance they can here to try and get him that hat trick. If they weren't already a little bit past first guys already to begin with, between the two of them, Lepinen and Laka. Pierce gives it off. Sorkin runs out of room at the top of the zone. He'll head back down with it. Sorkin, tied up by Baxter, gets dumped there. Palasek, closed off nicely by Dubinsky and Chelberg, and it'll be sent down ice where it will be icing here. 3:48 to go in regulation. RPI has a 4-3 lead.
Little bit of pressure there by Dartmouth. RPI doing a good job of getting sticks in the passing lane and winning that battle along the wall.
RPI out shooting the Big Green 35-11. They're out drawing them 35-28. 200 is the announced attendance here tonight, Coach. Hoping to have a few more tomorrow because it's a senior night and they're allowing team families in. And they're offside.
Yeah, Chisholm was way offside there. Well, that's
Harvard,
good.
Harvard Crimson come to town tomorrow.
Yes.
I was going to say the other weekend that could have been a sweep, if you put them together, was the Harvard-Dartmouth Road weekend. Because they shut both of them out. They were just both on a Tuesday.
Yep.
Usually those are condensed into to one weekend, but of course with the COVID rescheduling of games, they were forced to play those two games on midweek, going to Harvard and Dartmouth. And they won them both via the shutout, both shutouts by today's or tonight's starting goalie, Jack Watson, who for the second straight game has been lifted for Lyndon Marshall. Here's a shot on, save by Marshall. He'll hold on here. Now we get Townley has to be separated from an engineer there. He's just battling for a rebound.
Yep, he's just standing there.
Sometimes when you're standing too close to the crease, that's a problem.
And the fact that he's 6'2", I'm sure they take a little exception to that.
There's the shot. Seller again.
Yeah.
He's like, I don't know these freshmen. I know some of the other, Seller knows some of the other guys, right? Oh.
Yep. And in comes the
Waters
face wash,
gets his, yeah. Another sophomore, Waters didn't know him either. Seller's like, I don't recognize these guys.
Good to see him back in the lineup.
Oh, yeah. Picked up a goal the other night. Against Brown, I think. There's an empty net for the Big Green here with 3 minutes to go. Now you know they're definitely looking for Linden.
Oh, definitely. Yep.
Back out and down it goes. Yeah, we got an icing call here against RPI. 2:27 left. It feels like more than a one-goal lead right now. I think it's just because of the fact that the Big Green only have 12 shots. But, they're still just one shot away from tying this game.
Yeah, RPI has been doing a good job chipping away. They've been down, by two, down 3-1, and chip away to 3-2. And now they've chipped away. And here they are, leading 4-3.
RPI's last hat trick was by Todd Burgess against Princeton as that shot hits the outside of the net from Laka. And now it's in off of the skate of Lepinen. Unless it was off the defender's skate, then it might be Linden's goal. Oh boy, they're gonna have to look at this.
Yeah, they're going to.
I think it hit Lepinen's skate though.
Yeah, I agree. They're gonna look at it.
Yeah, we'll look at it here. Laka shot off the back of the net. Now Linden's going to throw it back off the boards. Yeah, that hit Lepinen's skate.
Yeah.
So it'll be an assist for Linden. An empty net goal.
Ooh, I don't know. He never got a stick on that.
No, hit his skate.
Yeah, the right one.
Previous play is under review.
They're definitely going to look at it because it went off a skate and it could be a kicking motion, but I don't think it is. Because I don't even think he knew where the puck was, let alone was kicking at it.
Yeah, he was trying to get a stick on it.
He was, and he was trying to find it first, which he never did. By the time he recognized where it was in the net.
Yeah. You know what? He's earned that. He's played a really
Otto Vile,
good game.
Yeah.
Real good game tonight.
If it is Otto Vile's, and we're pretty sure it is, it's his eighth of the year. And the third point of the game for Tuur Linden. And Laka.
Two assists.
Yeah. A couple helpers for Jacob tonight.
All three of them are plus.
Yeah, Lepinen also has an assist on the fourth goal for RPI. So Lepinen, two assists and a goal tonight. Linden, two goals and an assist. This top line, remember we were talking about them where they only had one goal.
Yeah.
How they were creating chances. And I'm not taking credit for these last couple of goals, but we definitely talked about them.
You can't bear.
They are. I was saying us.
And a helper to the play-by-play.
Okay, that's a good goal, says Chip McDonald.
RPI goal was scored by
what
number 11.
What do you think of the
Adovile Lepinen.
The
he was
here
assisted
for,
by number 19, Tuur Linden.
Do you see what he's wearing?
And by number 39, what, Jacob Laka.
The black shirt and the coat?
Yeah.
Time of the empty net goal, 17
you probably wore a suit
minutes,
every time,
46
right?
seconds.
With a sweater, probably?
RPI goal, 11.
You never win no tie?
His eighth of the
no,
season
never.
From
no
19,
never.
Linden, and 39,
but
Laka.
But you know what?
At 17:46.
Last year.
Right, COVID time.
He might have a tie underneath that sweater. I don't
oh,
know.
Oh, you might be right. I thought it was just a black shirt, but it is a sweater.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. The sweater just might be really high.
But I do know there are some teams and some coaches.
Yeah.
Bowling Green, when they came in.
Yeah, I remember that. You're right.
They just had the sweats on.
The tracksuit almost?
Yep. And last year, a lot of teams went.
Yeah.
A lot of coaches went to just wearing a tracksuit or something like that. No tie.
Puck behind the net. Now it's sent back to the point. Palasek gets it back. Minute 38 to go. RPI now up by two.
And there are some coaches now that will allow their teams to just, instead of sport coat and tie on the road, you just wear your tracksuit.
Empty net once again. So we're 6-on-5. Puck in front. Now it's Adamo. He'll flick it backhand towards the empty net, and it's in there. Of course, if Justin Adamo is going to score an empty net goal, it's going to be with his backhand.
Yeah, and you know what? It was almost like, all right, guys, here it is. He's going to flick that as slow as he can so that it can be as painful. Look, at just a little. Okay, here we go.
Nobody loves their backhand like Justin Adamo.
Oh, wonder, you know what? That'd be a great statistic to find out how many goals he scored this year on a backhand.
Are you trying to create work for me?
No.
Okay.
I'm just.
That's okay. I'll look it up. Morgan a shot, and that one just skips wide of the goal.
This
he had a man on the far side.
Play
that was love
in
it.
The period. Last minute of play.
Was in good position to stick that home, but just went right by him. Stevenson will stay in net now with 49 seconds left in the three-goal game. Cohane dumping in. That'll go up into the netting. We'll get a stoppage here.
RPI's fifth goal, an empty net goal, scored by number 22, Justin Adamo.
The goal for Adamo is his ninth of the year.
He was assisted by number three,
Laurie Sirdy. If I had to guess, I would say maybe four or five of them.
And by number 25,
Ryan
Nashie.
I would agree.
course, the one
time
that got
the
on SportsCenter.
Empty net goal, 18 minutes, was 51 seconds.
Yep. That's at least two. I can at least find you two more.
Yeah.
Out of his nine.
That's okay. The work's done.
Okay. Well, I hit the referee, hit Chip over on the far side. That left the zone. It should be offside. And it won't matter as it's sent back down the other way. Walsh has a man in front, spinning around and looking for Beaton, but it ends up on goal. Six goals in the game for RPI. And it's shot around behind with 4, 3, 2, and 1. And that's going to do it here as the Engineers have solidified their spot. Home ice here at the Houston Fieldhouse next weekend. And for the third time this year, RPI has scored 6 goals in a game, the second time in league play. And believe it or not, Coach, they are now 3-0 when they score 6 goals or more.
Saves in the third period for Clay Stevenson.
Well, 6 goals exactly, sorry.
Dartmouth, 15 of the
4-0 when they score
6
or more. They do have a 7-goal game this year.
Lyndon Marshall,
right,
2 saves in the third period.
Marshall
and Watson combined.
And Yale, they're tied at 2.
Yeah.
3 minutes left in the third. You've got Colgate up on Princeton 4-3.
9 saves.
5 minutes left in the third. You've got Cornell 1-0 over Quinnipiac. Brown is
final
up
1-0. RPI
4 6.
4 minutes
to go.
Wow.
And you
Dartmouth
defeated Hobbit 5-3.
The Gatherer Granola's player of the game. With
RPI
two goals
fans are
and
happy
one assist from RPI
with tonight's
number
effort,
19,
I'm sure, as the Engineers
Linden.
Get a 6-3 win. It's not too often that you're forced to pull your goalie and you get a win.
Yeah.
That's what happened here tonight.
Thank
Lyndon Marshall,
you for your support.
While he didn't see a ton of
Remember,
shots, he kept
night,
out the ones
the
he saw, and he picks up the victory
as
his ninth win of the year in a relief
against
effort.
Harvard.
Yeah, and you can't
game
really say that those goals
6
were
o'clock tomorrow night.
Because two of them were
deflected.
Right, no, you're right.
Thank
the
you
one
for
over his shoulder, maybe
tonight.
The one he wants back, but sometimes it doesn't matter if the goals are the goalie's fault or not. You feel like a goalie change could spark the team, and that's what we saw.
Exactly. Yep. Would certainly happen.
So good on, first of all, good on Lyndon Marshall to be ready to come off the bench. That's tough to do without a warm-up and going in play. He ended up making 5 saves in the game. There were only 9 total saves made. RPI only saw 12 shots. 3 of them went in. So RPI fires 38 the other way. They're 2-for-4 in the power play. A lot of good things going on. Now, closing out the year tomorrow, the regular season against Harvard, we'll see how that goes. But, they played them well the first time around. They have a chance to get them at home as well.
Yeah, they do. And, I mean, they just got to – you know what? It would be real nice to end the season on a sweep and win your homestand, 2 games. They haven't done it in a while. And it'd be nice to do it tomorrow night.
All right. Well, that'll do it for us here at the Houston Fieldhouse for our RPI TV crew. And Dan Fridge, I'm Perry Lascaris. We thank you for watching tonight's game. Your final score was the RPI Engineers 6 and the Dartmouth Big Green 3. You have been watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.